agenda, and why don't we get right to it? The first bill on the agenda, anything?
No, no, thank you very much, and I appreciate flexibility with a busy Tuesday.
Yep. First bill is print number 682, Senator Avella.
I have a question.
Sure.
Excellent. Is the Department of Buildings Commissioner qualified to make the determinations required of this bill?
That is a great question. So I wonder who is qualified to do that, if anyone?
Yes.
But I think the, we can speak to the sponsor, but I think the intention here is to not see these prop up in the types of places that they've propped up in throughout the city, causing consternation in various neighborhoods, and I think that is the goal of this bill, is to at least have some process. Right now, as you know, there's very little, if any, process in terms of the siting of cellular antennas. I know it's been an issue in my district and probably yours and throughout the city, and so I suppose the sponsor, Senator Avella, is looking to have some type of process, and I guess within the framework of the way these decisions are made in the city, the Department of Building is probably the most likely, you know, place to seek that guidance.
Yeah. And, you know, there's a set of requirements in this bill. Maintain a list of alteration permits, name the company utilizing the antenna, keep an updated period even of the electromagnetic frequency, making it all public, that I would support. I worry about the Commissioner of Buildings being required to assess compliance with the FCC for lots of reasons. So I'm going to vote without rec on that basis in hopes that the sponsor might go with the transparency as a step one and again figure out what further steps we need. But that would be a big step forward to get that transparency done without stepping on some issues that might make the bill never work.
I am going to keep my vote in favor, but I think you make a very, very good point. And I would, let's reach out to the sponsor and see whether or not there is a someone else or some other department within the city. Maybe there's no one in the city that is capable of making this decision and offering guidance. But let's see whether or not there's a better place to do it. The
and
next is
Senator DeFrancisco and Funky are without rec as well.
Great. I could tell you just a few years back, these brown boxes started popping up on every telephone pole, every other telephone pole on Staten Island, and the people that came and installed them really made a mess, and they would really do damage to trees, and they would put the boxes in the weirdest places on the poles. Some would be 20 feet up from the ground, others would be 30 feet up from the ground, and some would be crooked, and some would be rusted, and they really couldn't care less. When people would come out in the neighborhoods, they were just shocked to imagine that people that lived in the neighborhood would even care about the aesthetics of a neighborhood. After all, this was New York City. Who should care? Was the attitude. And so I think, and I remember speaking to Senator Avella back then, this was one of the things that sort of, prompted some sort of reaction in terms of, and when we reached out to the city, the last administration, to even ask questions about who it is that's putting these brown boxes on the poles, and where do they get to put them, and how do they get to do them, and what is the process, we were basically sort of chastised for asking.
Yes, and we've had the same issue across the city. It's infuriating.
Yep. Print number 687. An act to amend New York City Charter and Regulations requiring that one of the members of the Board of Standards and Appeals be a financial analyst with professional qualifications and at least 10 years experience as a financial analyst. Questions, comments? Bill is moved. The next is Senator Serrano. This bill would be referred to Finance.
It's an act related to the sale, lease, or other disposition of property of the New York City Department of Education, New York City Educational Construction Fund, New York City School Construction Authority, and New York City Housing Authority.
So I understand my colleagues' goals here and support them. In fact, I believe I co-sponsor have in the past a bill requiring ULURP for any disposition of NYCHA property. I have a concern here. Currently the Department of Education is acting in a way that has just shocked us all in a part of my community in terms of a lack of responsiveness and transparency when it comes to significant overcrowding that the community saw on the horizon and somehow the Department of Education ignored, leading to almost a quarter of zoned eligible kids in a public school in my district being rejected, significantly more than that, of course, without siblings, from the school. Something that the community organizes around, hoping for, planning for ahead of time. The department is now throwing up its hands and not offering solutions. It's extraordinarily frustrating. My only concern with this bill, and the reason that I have to vote without rec, or my most significant concern is what I should say, because I frankly haven't reviewed the rest of it as closely because I saw this concern, is the ability to sign leases quickly as well, which is critical. For example, in this instance, were the department willing to sign a lease and create an annex, we would have a very different situation. And I certainly don't want to give them any additional excuse not to do that. So I'm going to vote without.
Would this prevent that from happening, or would this?
So it's for all, as we read it, and actually, you know, if the council wants to correct the reading, you know, this is a big bill that, you know, I have to admit we read a little more quickly. But that it's not just leases of city-owned property, it would also be entering into leases for these agencies. If that's incorrect, then.
That's correct.
That is correct.
Yes.
So I'm going to, because I share your frustration and also the frustrations of Senator Serrano, I'm going to vote in the affirmative, but I'm going to ask counsel to ask the sponsor whether or not, because once again, Senator Squadron raises a very valid point, and I wonder if Senator Serrano would not agree in terms of actually signing a lease and ensuring that we don't put in place impediments to that process. And perhaps we can have this bill amended if the sponsor so chooses. Thank you.
Thank you.
Senator Funke also recorded without recommendation.
Okay.
Perhaps if the city of New York can hear us, perhaps they can prove their ability to make this current lease provision useful by providing some relief to PSA parents, which they have so far refused to do.
Sound traveling somewhat more slowly than light, but nevertheless reaching its goal. Bill 1992.
Senator Golden, an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to providing immunity from administrative action against certain New York City fire officers.
Questions, comments?
Senator DeFrancisco recorded without recommendation.
Okay, the bill is moved.
And forgive me, Senator Peralta.
Okay. Bill 3372, Senator Golden.
An act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to signage in school speed zones.
Questions, comments? Any in the negative? Bill is moved. Next is Senator Sampson.
An act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to requiring inspection stickers to be visible to the public. This would be on taxicabs.
Okay, questions, comments?
Senator Ort and Senator Funke without recommendation.
Okay, none in the negative, the bill is moved. 4252, Senator Bonasek.
An act to amend the general city law in relation to residential qualifications for service on the examining board of plumbers in the city of Middletown.
Local bill, any in the negative?
No.
Bill is moved. Next is 4269, Senator Golden.
An act to amend the administrative code in the city of New York in relation to the retirement, also amending the retirement and social security law and the general municipal law in relation to the disability benefits of members of the New York City Police and Fire Pension Funds.
Questions, comments? Any in the negative?
Senator Peralta and myself both in without recommendation.
Okay. The bill is moved. Next is print number 4271, my bill.
An act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to requiring the Department of Education in the city of New York to provide school bus service to students in kindergarten through fifth grade who reside 1/2 mile or more from the school.
I really appreciate the intent of this bill. We're going to, you know, I looked for the flag that was going to finance, and you worry about the cost and where those dollars come from, so they're not taken out of the classroom, which I know is not the sponsor's intent. I'm going to vote without rec on that basis. To be clear, it is a fiscal question of the moment for me, and only just a question, not
a policy. So clearly there is a cost associated with this, as there is a cost associated with providing any services in terms of education or other services the city and the state provides. The city has not talked to me about this issue. This year.
Oh, interesting.
I don't know if they've talked to you about the issue.
No, they haven't. How much would it cost, you know?
So,
Or have they told you?
No, they haven't told me what it would cost, but so here's the issue. So I believe that the kids in each district deserve the same level of services as they do in each district across the city. And so they can, the city can solve this. So the question becomes, well, there's a cost and we're going to have to spend money to provide these school buses. Well, these school buses would, this service, I must admit, would primarily affect my district in Staten Island and some areas of Queens. And the reason for that is that in other districts in Manhattan, the Bronx, and more urban districts, the city has solved this problem by building more schools. And so kids in Manhattan and the Bronx and in other places don't live, by and large, far from school. Because, and so, of course, the city had to spend lots of money, and there was a cost in terms of building those schools. So I would love for the city to give us the same level of service on Staten Island as they do in other places. And there are two ways to do it in terms of this issue. One is to build more schools so that the kids on Staten Island and in Queens don't live, need, can live as close to their schools as the kids in Manhattan and other places. Or they can, in the absence of doing that, which there has been, you know, obviously a legacy of not doing that, they can provide the, you know, the service, which I really think is a matter of public safety. And we hear about zero tolerance and the speed issue. You know, tragically, every, and I don't want to jinx it, but from time to time, we have young school children who are hit by cars because on Staten Island, you need to walk to school a further distance than anywhere else in the city, and we have fewer sidewalks, which the city has provided to spend the money on building. We have fewer stop signs and traffic signals. We have fewer buses. We have fewer trains. We have fewer mass transportation across the board. We have less of that, less of an investment, less money spent by the city on Staten Island than anywhere else, and so our kids are forced to travel these very dangerous routes to school, and that is why I believe that this is a very important public safety measure, and which is why I sponsored the legislation. I'm looking forward to the city actually talking to me about the bill.
And I look forward to that as well, and to them telling you how much it costs, and I want to be clear that I have an open mind on this bill at the moment.
Next bill is, bill is moved. Any negatives?
Senator Funky recorded without rec.
Okay, the bill is moved. Next is print number 4425, Senator Peralta.
This is in addition to the unconsolidated laws to provide for the establishment of a vendor policy commission in cities having a population of 2 million.
So this issue is one that I have spent a fair amount of time on in my life. I know that the committee council has as well. In fact,
Senator Peralta stealing your bills?
We can probably, no. I've never had this bill, but probably measure our age and times around on this issue. I need to admit I have not spoken to the sponsor about the bill, and it is such a complex, careful issue. I'm actually going to vote without rec now. Breaking the logjam on vending in exactly the kinds of ways he talks about, the number of licenses, the fairness and consistency of the enforcement, the understanding that you do have small businesses there and you also need to have effective regulation of them, is an inspiring thing to watch other members take on, having some of the scars of having taken on it before. But you know, in truth, I just need to look at every component of this and talk to every side of the table before I can vote yes for anything on vending. It's a promise I made to myself a half decade ago, so I will vote without rec. Thank you.
I sense introduction of vending legislation from our from my good friend here.
Thank you.
All right. Any negatives?
Senator Orton, the negative. Senator Funky, without recommendation.
Okay. The bill is moved. Final bill on the agenda today is 4505, which would be referred to finance.
It's an act to prohibit the expenditure of state and local funds relating to any trial of enemy combatants in any federal court in the state of New York.
Wow. I was very interested to see this bill. All I can say to our many viewers is more to come. I will be voting in the negative, no surprise to anyone, but let's have a discussion on this some other day.
We will.
I look forward to it.
I enjoy putting this on the agenda as much as for the reason that I believe it is a good piece of legislation, as I do enjoy the conversation I have with my colleague, Senator Squadron, about it.
Right. Likewise in the second part entirely, and the opposite of first. Thank you very much.
Okay, that concludes. Thank you, everyone.